could have injured people. You're a lawbreaker. Ouch, get away from me. Ew, leave me alone. I feel condemned, I feel dirty. Right? But if I say to you, listen, if you obey the instructions of the speed limit and you stay to the speed limit, those instructions will keep you safe, your children safe, and others safe. Ooh. You mean there's a way that I can stay safe on the road? Like a seatbelt? Uh-huh. So isn't instructions a little bit more accurate than law? The Hebrew word Torah comes from the Hebrew root word yara, which means to learn or to be instructed. Applauso. It doesn't mean law. It means instructions. So if my wife tells me, Moshe, listen, I'm doing this to instruct you about how to better get along with me, I can receive it. But if my wife comes home and says, now look, from now on, I'm wearing the pants, you're wearing the pantyhose. This is the law. I'm like, say what, woman? Law? I mean, what a difference. It makes a big difference. Instructions of a loving Heavenly Father. Ours indeed it is, but they have lost it forever. In this way, after Moshe had already received it. So in other words, Torah belongs to believers by faith in Yeshua. Torah does not belong to Messiah rejectors. That's the best thing. Write it down. Torah belongs to us as believers in Yeshua. It does not belong to Torah rejectors. Now in context, those of you who are following in context, are Jewish people who reject Yeshua Torah breakers? Sorry, the Bible doesn't teach dual covenant. Some Christians have such a love for Israel, and it's a love. It's a doctrine based on their love, not their hate of Jewish people. But there's such a love for Israel that they believe they're all automatically saved under the law of Moses, or the Torah of Moses. If that's true, then why did Yeshua go to Nick at night and say, hey Nick, you must be born again? That was Nick at night. Was Nachimon Jewish? Write it down. Jews are going to hell without the blood of Yeshua. It doesn't give you an advantage. And that's what Barnabas is saying. He's saying, yes, the Torah is ours. But don't make the sins of those who reject Mashiach thinking that it is theirs. So just the opposite. Instead of this being an anti-Torah epistle, Althea, it is the opposite. It says the Torah is for believers in Yeshua, not for Mashiach rejectors. Exactly the opposite. Isn't that beautiful? The Torah is for Yeshua lovers, not Yeshua rejectors.
Amen.
But wait a second, not so fast. Anna, you still with me? Somebody wake her up. But in context, Barnabas is not talking about Judaism. He's talking about the little king and the little horn. Islam also believes that the Torah is from Allah. And then Allah gave the Torah to Musa. So Barnabas says, I don't care if it's now, Judaism, or if it's in the future, that Enoch spoke about, the little king, uniting three kings, and leading the 10-nation Islamic Confederacy against Israel. Any Messiah rejector is not allowed to touch and live by the Torah, period. I'll say that again. Any Messiah rejector is not allowed to live by the Torah. They are using the Torah unlawfully. That's what Rav Shaul told Timothy, that the Torah is not for those who are lawbreakers only, but it is for the redeemed. We received the Torah when we came out of Mitzrayim. We were blood washed. We were redeemed. We were rescued. We were no longer slaves. And as free people washed in the blood of the Passover lamb, we received the Torah. The Muslims are not washed in the blood of the lamb. For it is written in the Quran, it says, Isa did not die on the cross. It was Judas, Allah, the great one, fooled the Jews. They thought it was Isa, but it was Judas. How mighty and great are the ways of Allah. So they bypassed the cross. They say that Allah took Isa to heaven without his death, burial, and resurrection. And yet if you speak to any Muslim, they'll tell you, we believe that Musa was a good Muslim. We believe Enoch was a good Muslim. We believe Isa, Jesus, was a good Muslim. Everybody was a Muslim. But, Islam says, that the Jews corrupted the Torah of Musa. So Muhammad came to straighten out the Torah that the Jews, through their filthy hands, because they corrupted the Torah, those Jews, and the Jews also made up the story about a Jesus dying on the cross. That Allah tricked the Jews because they were malevolent in their heart. Allah tricked them. The truth is, Allah in his great mercy took Esau to heaven without the cross. So when someone rejects the death, burial, and resurrection, the precious blood of Yeshua, Barnabas says, the Jewish shepherd says, the Torah is not for them. It's not for rabbinic Judaism without Yeshua, because that's legalism. Trying to please the Father without a king in Israel means you're the king, and now you're doing the Torah with yourself as king. And if you're a Muslim, and you're trying to do the Torah, if you don't receive Yeshua as the blessed Son of Yahweh, you have no power to do the Torah out of love, and you will use the Torah to kill, for the letter kills, but the Ruach gives life. So this is a double meaning. I believe there's a dual meaning. The point is this, write it down. Make believe you're at a leadership conference. Have all my leaders write down. No one without the blood of Yeshua is allowed to keep the Torah. People ask me all the time, FAQ. Rabbi, do I have to obey the Torah? No, not at all. Not at all. You don't have to follow the commandments of Yahweh. You get to. You don't have to. You get to. You see the difference? When they don't want you to keep the Torah, they say, we want to keep the blessing for ourselves. We don't want you to have all the blessings of obedience. And plus, Yahweh's will is that those who love Yeshua, what did Yeshua say? What did Yeshua say? If you love me, you will keep my Torah. Does Islam love Yeshua? No, they love an Esau who didn't die on the cross. It's a different gospel. It's a different... Do they love Moshe? No. They say the Torah has been corrupted by the Jews. They don't get to keep the Torah. It is we of all people who have the blessing and the opportunity to obey the Torah. Tudah Rabah Yahweh. I said Tudah Rabah Yahweh. I said, Tudah Rabah Yahweh. Baruch Hashem Yahweh. Amen. And you see, Zechariah, that's what Barnabas says. Barnabas says, it is for Nazarene Israelites who get to keep the Torah. Why? Why? Because we love Yeshua. So loving Yeshua is a prerequisite to obeying and getting to keep the Torah. That's a prerequisite. Verse 7. So anybody who rejects the Torah, rejects the Yeshua of the Brit Chadashah, does not get to keep the Torah. And when we believe, that's what Barnabas says, when we believe that others who do not receive the gospel, such as Muslims, such as rabbinical Jews, also obey the Torah, it says you are partaking in their evil because it is not for them, it is for us. Hallelujah, somebody.
Hallelujah.
Don't believe the lie that they keep the Torah. The Jewish people have added thousands of regulations to the Torah. And Muslims have changed the Torah because they allege that the Jews corrupted the Torah. So Yahweh said, don't eat a camel. It's unclean for you. Muhammad said, that's not what Allah told me. Allah said, you can have camel. Who's right? Who's right? Yahweh is right. Yahweh is right. Baruch Hashem Yahweh. Verse 7. For the scripture said, and Moshe was in the mount fasting 40 days and nights when he received the covenant from Yahweh, even the tables of stone, written with the finger of the hand of Yahweh. But when they turned to idols, they lost it. What's he talking about? Mount Sinai. Is Mount Sinai talking about the Quran or the Age of Grace and church steeples? None of the above. The whole issue here, Chris, is what? What's the whole issue here? In Barnabas. Torah. Amen? My golf buddy? That's what it's all about. Torah. That's the issue. Turn to your neighbor and say, that's the issue. Turn to your neighbor and say, I'm not talking about your issue. The issue discussed here is Torah. Do you understand the implications of what Barnabas is saying? Does anyone really understand the implications of what he's saying? He's saying it's not for anybody except born-again believers. Is that what the church taught you? They taught me we're not under it anymore. It's not for us anymore. Barnabas, the Jewish epistle, says the opposite. It's only for born-again believers. Any Messiah rejecter is not allowed to touch the holiness contained in the Torah, somebody. Baruch Hashem Yahweh. Todah Rabbah Yahweh. But notice the end of verse 7. Barnabas 4:7. But when our people, our fathers, turned to idols, they lost it. So it's not Jesus came and we don't have to do the law. No, it's the opposite. It's if you love Yeshua, it's yours. If you are not born again, it's not yours. Get your hands off of Yahweh's property. That's a little bit different than what we were taught. That brick, that's a little bit different than what we were originally taught. No wonder this book disappeared. Verse 8. Barnabas 4:8. For Yahweh said this to Moshe. Moshe, that sounds familiar. Father, Yeshua is synagogue. I don't want enough people hate me. Enough people talk about me. Enough people criticize me. Discipline them. Please, Father. Confront them. No. Moshe. Father, I have enough energy. I don't need two more. Moshe. It's your congregation. Shepherd, now. How about like now? Confront, talk, reason, admonish, rebuke. Okay, Father, a Thanksgiving. Now. Yes, Papa. Moshe, that sounds familiar. Get down quickly for your people. Father, I thought it was your, no, for your people, whom you brought out of the church, I'm sorry, out of the land of Mitzrayim, have done unlawfully. I think you missed that. Go back to verse 7, those of you who had the, I missed that. Go back to verse 7. But in other words, you could be an Israelite, but if you reject Yeshua as Mashiach and Savior of the world, then you've turned to idols and lost the Torah. That's what it says. When you reject Yeshua, you've turned to idols and lost it. Well, wait a second. Judaism told me different. Judaism told me if I accepted Yeshua, I became an idolater. Yahweh says the opposite. If you reject Yeshua, you are an idolater. And you've lost the right to obey the Torah. Is this stuff wild or what? All of our Jewish brothers and sisters who reject Yeshua, they are practicing idolatry, even with the Torah. That's what this says. I didn't make this stuff up. Sad. Very sad. Get down quickly. Those people you brought out from the land of Mizraim have done unlawfully. They've touched the Torah with unholy hands. And Moshe understood and cast the two tables from his hands. Symbolic of the broken covenant with both houses. And the covenant that was on them was broken. To the end that that of the beloved Yeshua might be sealed in our hearts in the hope of the Emunah. So in other words, when a human being sins and breaks the Torah, it is broken so that Yeshua might heal the heart by faith. Faith in Yeshua can restore the believer to Torah. Faith in Yeshua can restore the believer to Torah. The covenant upon Messiah rejecting Israel was broken. Not to destroy Israel, for the hope that when the beloved Yeshua might come, that their hearts would be sealed with the hope and faith in him, which can restore the broken Torah in our life. Now Torah is not broken. Now Torah is in our hearts. What did Yeshua do? Yeshua put the Torah what? In our hearts. We had broken the Torah. The Torah was broken as far as we were concerned. Yahweh took the Torah and it's not broken anymore. It works in our hearts. Come on, somebody. Amen. Do I have to shout to get you to shout? The Brit Chadashah has put the Torah in our hearts to show us that it works. The Torah is not broken. It works. Amen. Amen. But only if you first express Emunah in Yeshua. If you express Emunah in Yeshua, it works because now it's in our heart. It can't be broken anymore. We can't get to it. Yahweh's the only one that.
Hey. Hallelujah! Yeshua HaMashiach. Yeshua HaMashiach. Baruch Hashem Yahweh.
You know why the Brit Chadashah has put the Torah in our hearts? Because we can't mess with it no more. We can't get to it. It's hidden in our heart.
Yes.
As long as it was here, we can mess with it. Right? As long as it was in our hands, we could break it and mess with it and manipulate it. But here it's in the Aron Kodesh. This is the temple and this is the Aron Kodesh.
That makes a lot of sense.
Hallelujah!
Hey!
This is the, I just realized it. This is the Aron Kodesh. We are the temple of Yahweh.
Yes, sir!
Go ahead and give him a clap offering while I dry out.
Hallelujah!
Ayúdame, Yahweh! Ayúdame, Yahweh! Baruch Hashem, Yahweh!
Baruch Hashem! Baruch Hashem, Yahweh! Baruch Hashem!
Hey! Hey!
Fire!
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 Fire! Fire! Baruch Hashem Yahweh.
Hallelujah!
Toda Rabba Yahweh. My, 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 my.
Yes, sir!
Tada Rabba Yahweh. Verse 9. Now, look, verse 9. Barnabas 4:9. Now, though I wish to write many things to you, not as a rabbi, but even as fits one who loves you. Barnabas saying this, I'm writing to you because I love you. Not to fall short of the things that we have, Torah and Yeshua. I have been zealous to write to you as though I were the offscouring of you. Let us therefore give heed to the last days. Write that down. Let us give heed to the last day. I said, let us give heed.
Amen.
I said, let us give heed.
Amen.
To dry off in the last days. Woo!
Hallelujah.
Even what Daniel. Even Daniel.
Let us give heed to the last days. For the whole time of our emunah, will our faith, now listen, will profit us nothing. Unless now in the season of iniquity, in case you hadn't noticed, with Islam on the march, in the season of iniquity and among the stumbling blocks that are coming, we resist as become the sons of Elohim. You know what Barnabas is saying? I'm writing to you to resist the end time beast, to resist the end time forces, to resist the end time error. That's why we teach you Islam is the beast. Is it negative preaching? Not unless you have a negative mind. How can you guard and resist the beast if you're not prepared for the beast? If you think the beast is a Roman Catholic Church, can we talk? Do you realize the Roman Catholic Church hasn't killed anybody in hundreds of years? Well, they're drunk with the blood of the saints. Praise God. Revelation 13. No, they're not. There is the final generation. That's us or our children. And there is a beast who is drunk with the saints of the Kiddushim. And it's not the Catholic Church. They haven't killed anybody in hundreds of years. Amen? So Barnabas says, I'm not writing as a rabbi, I'm writing as a brother. I'm writing as a brother. So you won't be caught off guard? As one of you. I'm writing as one of you. That's what Barnabas said. Our faith is not just so we can go home and sing praises to Yahweh. Our faith is so we know the season of iniquity that we live in, notice, and so that the stumbling blocks or the blockheads who are coming will not destroy us, rather we will resist them. Does any of this make sense, Bert?
Yes,
the stumbling blocks that are coming. We need the epistle of Barnabas for the last generation, so when those stumbling blocks come, we can resist.
Amen.
Yes, sir.
That's why the word of Yahweh is a two-edged sword. There's a spiritual aspect, and there's a steadfastness, physical aspect to the sword. Nehemiah built the house of David with a sword in the hand and the word of the Spirit, the word of Yahweh, and the sword too. Double-edged sword. How foolish are we to think that Israel will be rebuilt without a two-edged sword? So Barnabas writing, saying, look guys, stumbling blocks are coming. But don't be depressed or overcome with fear. Rather, I'm sharing this with you so you will know who to resist and how to resist. Turn to your neighbor and say, who and how?
Who and how?
Stop howling.
How?
Stop howling. Say, who and how?
Who how?
Who to resist and how to resist. It's like you guys have heard me say on the radio. How many listen to the Addy Radio Network? Ministry, if you're going to do ministry in 2007, it's not like it was 15 years ago or 20 years ago. You don't do ministry like that anymore. 30 years ago, we didn't have to worry about hand grenades. 30 years ago, we didn't have to worry about Shiites entering houses of worship and gunning down the pocket. We didn't have to worry about that. If you're going to minister in 2007, you better know who you are. You better know where the stumbling blocks are coming from. And you better know it from Daniel, Revelation, and not from what your Sunday pastor told you.
That's right.
Go on the internet and read Yeshua's teaching. Ministry is not like, when I started, it was just fun and games. It was all about souls. We had a big chalkboard, number one, 5 souls. How about you, Sister Althea, Sister Kim? How about you? 6 souls. How about you? How about you, brother? How many souls did you win this week? 9 souls. This is not just about souls. This is about guarding the stumbling blocks and being overcoming Israel, overcoming the end time beast to flourish as children of light.
Exactly.
Ministry has changed. Don't you dare do ministry without a proper understanding of what it means to guard yourself, your home, and your flock with the sword of the Spirit and with proper means of self-defense. Resist. Hey, who does Barnabas tell us to resist? Uncle Fester? The Islamic beast started when Uncle La 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 La. Who does he tell us to resist? Morticia?
Never.